Oil, the oil and gas company with assets in Europe, the Americas and Africa, recently upgraded its stake in West African onshore operator Pan Minerals and Oil to just under 20%. Let's discuss it with the company's executive director, Neil Ritson.
Hi, good morning.
Thank you for being with us today. Now, can you take us through the reasons behind this move and the process as well?
Yeah, originally we made a 15% investment in Pan Minerals. Pan Minerals is a special purpose vehicle that owns rights to a field in West Africa that they need to put together the financing. And so the first stage was to assist them with the necessary funding to keep that alive. And that was our 15% investment in the company. Along with that, we got first right of refusal to participate in the financing. And then our second investment has taken us to 19.9%, which is the limit for investment in a Swiss company without making a takeover offer. And our further investment is now agreed through the financing package. So it's waiting for the banks to finalize their contribution to the financing, and then that will start to move forward. At the moment, because of confidentiality, we're not able to say too much about it, but it is a onshore field that has previously been discovered and tested the first well at over 2,000 barrels a day. So we're confident that it's close to infrastructure and there is the ability to sell that oil very quickly once the financing package is all put together. So the next announcement from us will be our contribution to the financing, and we'll see how that moves forward over the rest of the year.
Now, the company has three main assets, one in North America and two in Africa, East and West Africa now. Can you give us an overview of your operations?
Yeah, I mean, we're an investment company. We invest in other people's operations through Pan Minerals in West Africa. And in East Africa, we're active in Tanzania, where our operator is Aminex. We made a discovery there last year of gas onshore, which is the first commercial gas discovery onshore in Tanzania. And it's very close to the pipeline that's being constructed to take gas from the south of the country up to the capital, Dar es Salaam. We've been granted an appraisal license, and it requires us to collect some more seismic data and then drill some appraisal wells. And that's a program that's about to start. We would hope the seismic will start before the end of the year. And we've also been given an extension on our exploration period. There are more exploration targets in that license area that we need to follow up on. So we're very pleased with progress. We have been looking for a partner to work with. Both Aminex and Solo are willing to partner with someone else, but we haven't found the right terms yet. So in the meantime, the program continues, and the construction of the pipeline is going to give us an access to the market, which is absolutely critical for gas. I mean, gas can very easily be stranded, and in this case, it won't be. So that's very encouraging. Our investment in Canada has not gone so well. We made that was our first investment in a small company in Canada looking to redevelop a field in Ontario. It's been very slow, and our investment we would consider to be underperforming at this stage. And we've had an offer, indicative offer to buy it from us, and so we're considering doing that by the end of the year in order to reinvest elsewhere. That's you know, the sensible thing to do. Keep your money working, and we'll do that. Whether it's invested into West Africa or into a new venture, then you know, that's something we can decide at the time.
Yeah, I was actually going to go back to Africa. I was wondering if there were further investment opportunities for you in the region.
Yeah, without a doubt. That the east-west, I mean, it kind of leaves the north available for further investment, certainly. Yeah, we're very much focused on Africa as a place to invest at this stage. There are a lot of opportunities, and we constantly review opportunities to invest. We tend to take them one at a time, so let's get this Pan Minerals one completed and announced to the market, and then we'll be starting to talk about the next one. It may well be in North Africa, but no decision has been taken yet. But a Pan-African investment strategy is certainly where we're looking at the moment.
Do you believe in all the hype surrounding Morocco at the moment?
There is undoubtedly a play there to be chased, and it's something that we will take a look at. It's not at the forefront of our thinking, though. I have to say that we're not close enough to what's going on there to think we have a competitive advantage. But it's a country being hyped up. But that's what the oil industry does. It has its fashions and it moves around. And sometimes you have to get ahead of the fashion rather than follow it. So we'll be looking probably elsewhere at the moment for things that are overlooked by other people.
Thank you very much, Neil.
Okay.
That was Neil Ritson, the Executive Director of Solo Oil.